I went right. and played through all of the co-op missions in Space Marine. So there's the campaign, which has co-op, but then there's a dedicated set of co-op missions that are primarily for co-op, and they have their own upgrade system and perk system and weapon unlock system. Mm-hmm. They are shorter missions. So the main missions in the campaign are like an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours long. The co-op missions are 30 to 40 minutes long because you're supposed to be playing them in a row, like bam, 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 bam. They're really, really good. Mm-hmm. And in particular, you fight a better set of bosses in the co-op missions than you do in the campaign. Like, there are more bosses, and they are better, different bosses in the co-op stuff than the campaign.
Yeah, I saw some gameplay of, like, basically someone that was just, like, jumping into the air, jetpacking, and then axing down on opponents and, like, not shooting at all. And I was like, huh, they can actually do that.
In the campaign, you play as, like, a fairly generic guy who will, at some point, get access to a wide variety of weapons that don't fit into any particular class, right? In the multiplayer and in the co-op stuff, there's a class system. So, like, the assault class is I have a jetpack and a melee weapon and a pistol.
Okay.
But I'm trading having a primary weapon, like primary ranged weapon, for the ability to jetpack around and do, like, death from above all over the place. And in the co-op, you can continue to upgrade that character to get all sorts of benefits. One of the ones was if you do a perfect dodge with the jetpack, it regenerates your jetpack charge. Nice. So you are just
mobility
going all over the place. But it has a difficulty scaling system on 4 difficulty levels, kind of like a Left 4 Dead or like a Dark Tide, where you need to increase your character's power and upgrade your weapons to continue to go. So now that I've done every single thing in Space Marine, that game is incredible. Like, that is a really great campaign, a really good, if simple, PvP experience with bad servers, which they're apparently working on, and a completely separate, different game that's the co-op stuff that would kind of be a pretty good game on its own.
Hmm.
And they're all in the one package.
All three different... Yeah, you were mentioning last week that it's basically 3 different games, and they're
Three different 8 out of 10s are combining to make, like, a 9 or a 9.5. Like, it is excellent.
Is this the best Warhammer-related game?
Oh, that's so controversial! That's so hard to say!
What do we...
Maybe... Maybe.
Okay. Okay.
People would say Vermintide 2, Space Marine, Mechanicus, and Dawn of War 2, Retribution, and Total Warhammer 2 are like the 5 best ones.
Vermintide was talked about for a while.
Bolt Gun's also really good. And Rogue Trader is good, but it's not done. But yeah, so there's like 400 Warhammer games, and and I just listed like the best ones.
Mm-hmm.
Like there are like 10 incredibly excellent Warhammer games, and then there are a lot of other Warhammer games, mm-hmm. many others.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, no, this is excellent. Okay. Like, this is a really fucking great shooter. The multiplayer feels like the good times of Gears of War. And the co-op is fun. And it has a huge amount of progression and like cool little doohickeys about it. Yeah, it's great. I loved it.
It's probably also relative depending on the genre and stuff. Like, if you want team multiplayer versus the horde or third person shit or, you know, all that stuff. You know,
the way that it tends to work out with Warhammer is that each genre will have one really good one.
Mm.
Like, if you want a real-time strategy game, you're better off playing Dawn of War 2. If you want a Total War game, you would play Total Warhammer 2 or 3. If you want an action game, you would play Space Marine.
Right.
Etc. If you want an XCOM game, you could play Mechanicus or Chaos Gate. If you want to play football, you'd play Blood Bowl 2, I think. I'm not sure.
And when would I boot up the Saturn and pop in Space Hulk?
You wouldn't. like, those games being worth playing is a relatively new phenomenon.
Okay.
They used to be, like, universally terrible. But yeah, no, Space Marine 2, good. Also, I will reiterate it, you can really dress up your little Space Marine dolls real pretty.
Mm-hmm.
I spent a bunch of time making all my guys look like pre-heresy Death Guard, and they came out great. I was very happy about my pretty little spacemans.
Is there like a base that you can like rotate that them on and like actually like is it simulating?
So it's not. It doesn't give miniatures. You like a miniature look.
Okay.
It is like you are going. So what it is you go into the you know like your class selector kind of screen, but instead you just head over to the appearance tab, and in the appearance tab you have two sets of options. One is, what do you want the pieces on your armor to look like? Do you want to have a helmet on? Do you want to have the backpack covered in tabernacles? Do you want to have writing all over your shit? Do you want to have solid gold, you know, whatever, right? Mm-hmm. The pieces. And then you go one tab over and goes, well, what do you want the coloring to be? And step one is, do you want to be one of the existing 40 fucking whatever chapters that are in the game just ready to go, right? But if you don't want that and you want to customize it or change it in any way, you go down to the custom coloring section and it goes, here's your base, and you set your base. And then it goes, do you want to create new rules? And new rules are, I want the base here, but I want the helmet like this.
Okay.
And you can combine all of those in any which way you want.
So just go nuts. And
to make your prettiest boy.
Right.
Unfortunately, there are a lot of... I think people are calling it the Crayon Eaters chapter of the Space Marines, which is the motherfucking Lego Roblox looking freaks with the bright red arm and the bright yellow arm and the green leg and the blue leg.
You know what? I mean, that's the price for freedom, right?
It literally is.
That, like, Armored Core needs to allow you to do everything, and that means eyesores included.
Yeah.
So fuck it.
I do really like that every single time I've seen them mentioned, I see people say, oh, it's the Crayon Eaters. Like, that's a fucking nice chapter. but yeah, that's been pretty much it this week. I should mention, every single game I talked about, I got sent a free code this week. I didn't buy any of these. So take that under consideration. Except for Anotria, because I got sent a free code and I couldn't play it for more than 40 minutes. That's bad. If I had bought it, yikes, that I would have been probably a little more scathing. Don't buy it. Oh, yo, not Satisfactory. I bought Satisfactory on Early Access like fucking 4 years ago. That game's good. You should play it.
Okay.
The conveyor belts touch.
Yeah. That's the kind of, well, there needs to be an opening in my life for that style of game, and
that style of game is a great game to do one stream of ever, because I did one stream of it and people were like, what is this? And then I did the second one and everyone's like, we're playing with our dolls in the background also.
Yeah.
If you want to check out my show this week, it's twitch.tv/PatStaresAt. I'm also on Adeptus Ridiculous this week. Bricky, Shy, and DK invited me over to talk about getting into Warhammer and what gets people into Warhammer, with a side of Space Marine 2 just came out. This week is Plucky Squire, Dead Rising, and Frostpunk. So go check that shit out.